Good day. I'm Marion Broom, the Dean of the Duke University School of Nursing. And I'm just so honored to be able to share a few of my thoughts with you on this terribly important occasion, honoring nurses who have served so well the last year during our COVID epidemic. I'd like to start with a quote by Michelle Obama, "Grief and resilience live together." And there's been a lot of grief this past year for everyone, loss of people in their lives, people that they loved, loss of patients, loss of colleagues, but also just loss of our traditional interactions and with others that are important to us. But during that time, we also have to pat ourselves on the back and remember and think about how resilient we were during that year, how resilient you are, every one of you who've come through this last year. Early last spring, America and indeed the world watched smart, capable, and most importantly, caring and compassionate nurses meet head-on the tremendous winds of change. None of us were prepared for these headwinds. Yet nurses, as they have done for hundreds of years, and here at Duke for almost 100, got to work solving problems, caring for people. And those problems were not of their own making, but it did not matter. Your fear was palpable, and so was your courage to get up every day, leave your families, and show us exactly what a nurse does. And now it's been a full year, 365 long days, and Duke nurses are still modeling the way. You keep giving to your patients, to your colleagues, and to our students, your students. I know you are oh so weary, yet you keep on giving. Many say our students will mark this time in their career when they had to learn to be a nurse in many different ways as a turning point. The gift of your practice this year to our students was to show them the courage it takes to be a nurse. That lesson could only be learned from you as they watched you with your patients, your families, your colleagues in other health professions, whether you were in the ICU, in the clinics, in other units, or even in home settings. For that, I, on behalf of all the faculty of the School of Nursing, thank you, thank you, thank you. It's a gift that is yours alone to share, and you did so. You did so with grace and fortitude. I'd like to close with another quote, this time from Gregory S. Williams. On the other side of the storm is the strength that comes from having navigated through it. Raise your sails and begin. And my colleagues, we could not, the country could not, and certainly we at Duke University School of Nursing could not have done this without you and your incredible willingness to give all you had and let our students be part of that. So thank you again. I have been in nursing this June 47 years, 48 years. And I've always been proud to be a nurse, but never as proud as I have been this year. And now I'd like to invite the Assistant Dean, Reverend Bruce Puckett of the Duke Chapel, to give some remarks.
It is my honor to share a few words with you today. While I'm a preacher by training, speaking to a group of people connected with the nursing profession really feels like talking to family to me. You see, my mom was a nurse, and her sister is a nurse. And my dad's sister and her husband are both nurses. And four out of the five cousins on that side of the family are also working in the nursing profession. This proximity to people who have made their career and understood their vocation to be in the field of nursing has given me a firsthand look into the dedication, sacrifice, courage, and commitment it takes to day in and day out face the challenges of caring for the sick and for the hurting. Seeing some of the realities of the nursing life up close as I grew up has given me a deep appreciation for the significant way you serve our communities. So the first thing that I want to say to you today is thank you. Thank you for using your talents, abilities, skills, and gifts to care for strangers and friends and anyone who comes in need. Your service in everyday life, in normal times, as well as the most challenging ones, is an inspiration. And our communities and our world would be worse off without it. So thank you. As I've reflected on the last year and the crisis of the COVID-19 pandemic and what it's meant for our whole world, I've thought often about the role of touch in our lives. We all know that little things like handshakes and hugs with acquaintances have mostly been eliminated from our daily lives. Pats on the back, a hand placed on a shoulder in consolation, and high fives given in celebration are just some of the common touch casualties of this time. For many, that has created a sense of isolation and loneliness. One article recently published talked about how the physical isolation of the last year has led to a breakdown in people's mental health from not receiving the kinds of physical touch from others that they need. As one neuroscientist put it, the human body has built all its models based on touch received from caregivers. We are utterly reliant on the caregiver to satisfy the body's core needs. Little can be done without touch. Humanity needs touch. And yet we've become painfully aware over this past year that touch is dangerous. I'm sure you, who are used to donning gloves and washing your hands regularly to do all your daily work, have grappled with the danger of touch long before novel coronavirus became popular parlance for lay people. But for folks like me, the risk people take to provide for the need of touch had not been regularly on my mind until this year. Now, even I notice the risk everywhere. Recognizing the danger of touch has made me all the more grateful and all the more inspired by your commitment, your courage, and your care. As you know, to be on the front line of medical provision, you choose to show up even when the risks are great and the potential harm for yourself is real. I recall the early days of the pandemic when so little was known about how the virus spread and how to protect oneself, and yet you showed up to provide life-saving touch to patients in your care. Some of you came out of retirement to help. Some of you entered the profession for the first time knowing that great challenges were ahead. And some of your colleagues even gave their lives because they showed up when others were told to stay home. These colleagues across the country and the world will be memorialized for their sacrifice and remembered regularly. The candle that is on the altar during this program will remain in the atrium of the Pearson Building to serve as a reminder of those nurses who have given their lives in service. While the need for touch and the danger that comes with offering it has only recently been part of popular reflection, people have recognized for millennia that touch is powerful, potentially healing, and risky. Being a minister in the Christian tradition as I am, I often look to the life and teachings of Jesus for inspiration and for a deeper understanding of life. Jesus seemed to understand the potency of touch for healing and care. Repeatedly through his life, Jesus broke social custom and religious norms in order to touch others for the sake of their healing. when he was presented with a mother suffering from a life-threatening fever, he touched her. When he was approached by a man suffering from a physical and social death-dealing skin disease, Jesus touched him. Over and over, at great risk to himself, much like nurses, Jesus touched those in critical condition. Like nurses, he saw and responded, delivering essential care. Though the society around him emphasized the physical, social, and religious risks of touching people who were unwell, Jesus touched them anyway. Jesus' act of healing touch revealed how the touch that is given in care for others can be one of the most sacred acts of human life. You who are in the nursing profession are ambassadors of touch. This means that your work is some of the most sacred, most blessed, and best work in the world. Over the last year, you've been the ones who've touched six strangers when we've been told not even to visit with people outside of our households. Over the last year, you've been the ones who've held the hands, touched the arms, and wiped the foreheads of people scared to death they would die of this virus. Over the last year, you've been the ones who've provided touch in the absence of family members who've been barred from hospital rooms and waiting rooms alike. Over the last year, you've been the one who's opened the door to hope when the future was just filled with fear. And over the last year, you've touched with gentle care so many who've breathed their last apart from anyone other than you. All of this is to say that over the past year, your work has been sacred and holy work, the very most important kind of work anyone can do in the world. So I will end where I began, saying again, thank you. Thank you for being ambassadors of touch. Thank you for extending hope with your hands. Thank you for putting yourself on the line for the sake of others. Your work is sacred. Your work is honorable. Your work is essential to the life of our community. May you continue to have the strength and endurance you need to continue your vital work for days and weeks and months and years to come. I now invite Dr. Jennifer Forsman Stoyle, two-time Duke alumni, to present a musical tribute, You Raise Me Up.
When I am down and my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. Raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong shoulders. raise me up to more than I can be.
I would like to introduce Dr. Ernest Grant, President of the American Nurses Association, and Dr. Richard Ricciardi, President of Sigma Theta Tau International, to give remarks, followed by a musical number by Dr. Valerie Howard and Dr. Bridget Carter.
Hello, I'm Dr. Ernest Grant, President of the American Nurses Association. I want to take this opportunity to extend my sincere greetings and best wishes to the students, alumni, faculty, staff, preceptors, and all nurses in the Duke Health System. As we continue to work through this pandemic, I want to commend you on your dedication through these very tumultuous and trying times. When we embarked on the Year of the Nurse at the beginning of 2020, no one could have predicted what we are facing today. Yet, we're reminded now, more than ever, of the true strength and commitment of this profession. Nurses have always answered the call to serve their country and communities during times of crisis. Since COVID-19 took hold in communities across the nation, nurses continue to provide care while risking their own health and safety. You are providing expert, compassionate care, leading by examples, shaping healthcare policy, and advocating for resources. ANA has been and will continue to advocate in many ways with numerous stakeholders for much-needed workplace protections and evidence-based protocol. As ANA celebrates 125 years this year, we have also joined with our global colleagues in continuing the Year of the Nurse and have shifted our focus towards promoting your health and well-being, recognizing your role in meeting the needs of patients, and honoring you and your contributions in every way that we can. Despite the difficult times that we're living in, I challenge you to make this extended Year of the Nurse yours. Share your experiences. Take on leadership roles. Focus on your physical and mental health, and take every opportunity to advance your professional development. This year has tested us on many levels. However, as schools, as organizations, as leaders, and above all, as nurses, we have risen to the challenges. With the arrival of life-saving COVID-19 vaccines, we're hopeful that we've turned the corner. And while the last year has tested us on many levels, we have confronted this crisis with grit, resilience, and kindness, embracing a common spirit of being in this together. And for that, I have never been prouder to call myself a nurse. I applaud the Duke School of Nursing and the Duke Health System for creating this space for nurses to honor their fellow nurses. And I thank each of you for your continued fortitude, dedication, and ingenuity as together we continue to excel, lead, and innovate in the days and weeks and months ahead. I look forward to a future in-person event, but until that time, stay safe, stay healthy, and keep advocating. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Rick Ricciardi, a professor at George Washington University in the Center for Health Policy and Media Engagement, and also the president of Sigma Theta Tau International. And I'd like to thank Dean Broom for this opportunity to provide a short tribute to the nurses and all healthcare workers at Duke Health and also in the School of Nursing at Duke. Let me begin by saying it's been a really tough year on many, many people. And we really, really have seen so many nurses that have been at the forefront of doing great things, to include the nurses at Duke. So thank you for all your efforts. It's been so challenging, I know, both in acute care, in primary and ambulatory care, as well as long-term care. We each have individual and specific problems related to COVID and the delivery of care outside of COVID. And nurses have been there to be part of that delivery, to bring the communities together and to mitigate poor outcomes by really, really pushing themselves forward. On a personal note, I'm well aware of the sacrifices that nurses have made to come up front to fight the war on COVID. Last year in 2020, I was recalled back to active duty and spent 8 months fighting the war against COVID at Fort Leonard Wood, which is one of the major military training bases. So I'd like to close this tribute and say thank you to you all by reciting a poem that I wrote specifically for this occasion. And it's entitled, The Plight of the Healthcare Worker. Behind the mask emerges a cacophony of sensations, layered through waves of seemingly unconstrained deftness, interlaced with anger, fear, frustration, and sparks of hope, sometimes numb, never tranquil, always aware of the unceasing responsibility that speaks deeply into an inner, unremitting passion and purpose, crashing through the horror and pain, disrupting the disruptors, bringing an inner, unforeseen, and welcome strength to fibers, robustly pulling corporeal entanglements back to a cautious harmony of unpretentious strength and sagacity. So in the future, I look forward to hope, and together we all can get through this. Be well, be safe, and thank you for all your efforts.
I heard there was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled key composing, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
I did my best. It wasn't much I couldn't feel, so I tried to touch. I've told the truth, I didn't come to fool you. And even though it all went wrong, I stand before the Lord of song with nothing on my tongue but our two-time DUSON alumni and DUHS neonatal nurse practitioner, Dana Robinson, to give remarks.
Hello, everyone. I am honored to share in this moment with you as both a neonatal nurse practitioner and as an alumni of the Duke University School of Nursing's ABSN and Master's program. The last year has brought several challenges that many of us didn't think we'd face. If any of you are like me, you've experienced heartbreak professionally, personally, politically, and socially. You may feel unheard, and you may feel exhausted. Despite all this, you press forward as nurses. I am constantly in awe of my colleagues who continue to give of themselves freely as caregivers and as educators. That is the spirit of a nurse. We continue to walk the long road with our patients, supporting them through what is often the most difficult time of their lives. Bearing witness to the nursing spirit, as well as the opportunity to make a difference alongside other wonderful caregivers, is what helps me deeply engage in my work every day. It helps me to be present for all of the trials and triumphs from each birth to each final goodbye. I couldn't imagine being anywhere different, even in these trying times. I continue to find joy in caring for the tiniest patients, encouraging the nervous parent, and seeing our critically ill infants thrive. To every nurse out there, I hope you continue to find joy in your work, irrespective of the odds. I hope that you know that you are loved, seen, respected, and appreciated. You are the glue that holds healthcare together now more than ever. Our patients and their families rely on you. We rely on one another. There is great purpose in your work, and there is no amount of notoriety, recognition, or compensation that can fully repay you for your sacrifices. I would now like to invite Zui Tan Go, ABSN student and May 2021 graduate, to give remarks.
Today we gather with respect, honor, and tremendous appreciation for our nurses. We will never forget the year 2020, a year of great turmoil and pain by the COVID-19 pandemic that brought fear to our communities and death of millions. We as Americans are one and have always overcome tragedies. Nurses have made history. Their contributions belong with the heroic actions of first responders on September 11, 2001. When we were safely at home, nurses fought on the front lines. When our world shut down, nurses marched on. When patients were on the edge of losing their lives, nurses held on tight. Nurses, you are the backbone of Duke Health, carrying our weights for humanity. You have sacrificed your lives in safety and placed your families at risk in fighting this pandemic. You are a beacon of hope for us all, inspiring a world of love, compassion, and equality, regardless of our differences. Together, we can defeat these invisible enemies, this virus, and discrimination. Thank you for giving to our profession, communities, and world. You have shown us the meaning of resilience. Even when surrounded by the most challenging of circumstances, with our hearts, our minds, and our hands united, we can overcome great obstacles. Thank you for pushing us into new frontiers of clinical care, research, and education. You have shown us the untapped strength of our united community. We have seen your heroic work on the front line. We have seen your perseverance since day one. We have seen your courage and selflessness. To our families, thank you for your unconditional support and love as we fulfill the calling of our trusted profession. You give us strength. I want to take a moment to honor and remember the nurses who lost their lives in this battle. We are forever indebted to you and your families. Our profession and the torches of our oaths shine bright because of you. We will always remember your ultimate gift. I speak for many with our humble spirits and deepest gratitude. Thank you, nurses, from the bottom of our hearts, for this great honor. by your courage, commitment, and sacrifice for us all. You are our heroes. I now invite Lisa Barker, DUHS manager of the medical ICU, to share a musical tribute, The Climb.
The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most. Just gotta keep going, and I gotta be strong. Just keep pushing on. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's a climb. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. It's the climb.
I would like now to introduce Dr. Marianne Fuchs, Vice President of Patient Care and System Chief Nurse Executive, DUHS and Associate Dean of Clinical Affairs, Duke School of Nursing, and invite her to give closing remarks.
Thank you, Lisa, for that introduction. 2020 began with excitement as the World Health Organization designated it as the Year of the Nurse and the Nurse Midwife, honoring the 200th anniversary of Florence Nightingale's birth. No one could have predicted just how fully nurses around the world would deliver on that proclamation. The COVID-19 pandemic has impacted all of our lives in so many ways. The lingering uncertainty, the toll on our well-being, and the way that we deliver healthcare is forever changed. As resourceful as nurses are, we are not immune to the challenges that we are leading through. Our ability to innovate, mobilize, advise our communities, and advocate has been remarkable. I've been privileged to witness firsthand the incredible collaboration of leadership of nurses across our entire health system and the university in response to this ongoing threat to our nation's health. I want to recognize our nursing workforce, our faculty and students whose lives have been impacted in ways that we could not have ever imagined during this time. Through all the uncertainty and upheaval in 2020, nurses remained persistent in their commitment to the well-being of their patients and their communities. The most important thing that I can say to each and every nurse at Duke in this moment is thank you. Thank you for the sacrifices that you have made this year, for living apart from your families in order to keep them safe from the virus, for delivering compassionate, high-quality care in rapidly changing circumstances, for going the extra mile to keep families updated on their loved ones when they could not be with them during hospitalization, for advocating for equity in healthcare and equality in society, for your innovation in delivering care and training students differently, and to the nurses who lost their lives to COVID-19, we honor you. Reba Beavers was a beloved member of our Duke Regional family for more than 43 years, with 30 of those years in nursing leadership. She lost her life to the coronavirus and is remembered for her caring approach and love of patients, as well as her thoroughness, organizational skills, and mentorship. The delivery of healthcare is hard work. Nurses do not choose this profession because it's easy. We choose nursing because we want to make a difference. I believe the founder of our profession would agree that we have overwhelmingly made a difference, and that our dedication and commitment to continuing to serve others and improve the health of our planet is unwavering. I am humbled each and every day by the energy, dedication, can-do attitude, all hands on deck, and expert care that our team delivers each and every day. There is no challenge too big for us to overcome. I extend my heartfelt thanks to all of you for your enduring leadership and commitment to our mission during this unprecedented time. As we conclude the program, I would now like to introduce the Nightingales to provide their rendition of Dear Old Duke, followed by a special video, You Didn't Have To, that was created by country music stars Brown and Gray and the Thank a Nurse, Wear a Mask movement from Nurses Everywhere.
Dear old Duke, thy name we'll sing. To thee our voices grace will raise. To thee our anthems ring in everlasting praise. And though on life's crossing our fates may far us bear, we'll ever turn to thee, our alma mater dear.
Here's to the ones that don't ever take credit. Here's to the ones that won't admit it. I hope you know we're all thanking God for you. And here's to the ones on call all night. Don't think twice about the sacrifice. Here's to the extra mile that you take it to. Yeah, here's to the frontline warriors, to being brave for all of us. You didn't have to make him laugh or hold her hand like that. You didn't have to love, but you did, just to make them all feel better, yeah. You didn't have to pray. Have to risk your life. If everybody loved like you did, the world would be a whole lot better. You didn't have to. No, you didn't have to. No, no.
You give it all, like there ain't much to it. Fires all around and you walk right through it. I hope you know we're all thanking God for you.
The frontline warriors, to being brave for all of us. You didn't have to make him laugh or hold her hand like that. You didn't have to love, but you did, just to make them all feel better.
You didn't have to.
frontline warriors to being brave for all of us.